It's time for Rabbi Minkowitz's weekly Torah lesson, a place where life's most difficult questions are answered. Here with his spiritual perspective and insight, Rabbi Minkowitz.
Welcome to our weekly Torah lesson. This week's Torah lesson is on Pesach. The question of the week is, what is true freedom? So in this week's Torah lesson, we're discussing the holiday of Passover. So the Rebbe brings down an interesting verse about the Jewish people when they left Egypt, and it says in Deuteronomy that God loved lekachas goy mikerev goy. He took out a nation from another nation. In other words, the Rebbe explains, goy means the Jewish people were a nation. They were separate, they had their own land, Eretz Goshen, they were religious, they studied Torah, they did the mitzvot. What was the problem? They were mikerev, they were close to another nation. What does the Rebbe explain? What does it mean they're close to another nation? It means when you're close to another nation, it means by osmosis, you get affected from the environment, from the philosophies, ideologies. And ultimately, for the Jewish people to really be free, God had to pull them out of Egypt and bring them to their own land, Eretz Yisrael, where not only will they be a nation dedicated to God, but they'll be free from all their surroundings and have total focus and not be affected by an outside environment. What is Yetzias Mitzrayim? What does it mean to going out of Egypt? To know that we are servants of God and not servants of any other God. Any other God could be any environment that you're affected by, whether it's a neighbor, whether it's a friend, whether it's society pressures, whether it's technology, whether it's clothing, whether it's cars or houses, whatever it may be that's causing you not to be who you want to be and who you need to be, that is slavery. So to answer the question, what is true freedom? True freedom is being able to make healthy and honest choices without being affected by anyone or anything. And ultimately, true freedom is having a pure connection to God, not disturbed by anyone's opinion or thoughts or feelings. Thank you so much for joining us for our weekly Torah Thought. I'd like to wish you all a happy, kosher, and a truly free Passover. May this be the beginning of true freedom for each and every one of us in our personal lives and for the Jewish people as a whole, and ultimately with the coming of Mashiach speedily in our days. I would like to dedicate this Torah lesson to Rashi, my sister-in-law of blessed memory, who has brought unity to her family, community, and the Jewish people around the world by focusing on the positive of every individual and inspiring others to be positive and thereby creating true Kedusha and true holiness. May her neshama be elevated and blessed by the Torah study that we are studying in her memory. Thank you so much for joining us for our weekly Torah lesson. Please join us for live classes here at Chabad. Thursday at 11, Nechami does a Parsha class. Thursday evening at 7, there's a class, Teachings of the Arizal on the Parsha. Shabbos morning, we have a Kabbalah class based on the teachings of the Rebbe at 9 o'clock, followed by davening and followed by a grand Kiddush. Shavua Tov, and have a great week.
It's Steinomite.